win an unlimited Black Lotus just by shopping at the Channel Fireball Marketplace in October. Every $10 gets you an entry.
The Night of the Living Dead! As always, I'd like to say thank you to Channel Fireball for sponsoring this video. And Channel Fireball is going to be the host of the Gathering of Magic Gathering. That's right, I'm talking about Magic the Gathering Las Vegas this November. Do you want to play Magic against other people? In tournaments, in free play, all the different formats you could ever imagine? Well, then you should check out Magic the Gathering Las Vegas November 19th through 21st. You can check out their website as well. It is mtglasvegas.com. You can see what events they're going to be hosted, the kind of actions that they're taking to make sure that this is a safe event for people to attend, and to find out who else is going to be attending. I know that a lot of content creators in the Magic the Gathering space are going to be attending, so you should check out Twitter if you want to see where they have revealed their attendance. It's going to be hype. Hello everybody and welcome to Jank Tank. I'm Amy the Amazonian and today we're going to be playing Standard Zombies. That's right, it's a graveyard smash. Not the Monster Mash though. I actually did have an idea for Monster Mash deck. You can get all of the monsters of the Monster Mash in Arena, but they don't work very well together. They're fun though, they're fun. So what is this deck? It is a zombie tribal deck in Standard, which means that it's running a couple lords, things like Narfi, Death Priest of Merkel, things that reward you for getting lots of zombies out, and then just mostly zombies. Because this is a tribal deck in black, it does give us one really nice advantage. Crippling Fear. I can -3/-3 my opponent's side of the board and keep my own side of the board alive, unless they happen to have something that's bigger than -3/-3, then it doesn't die, or shapeshifters. Ugh, shapeshifters, am I right? Imagine playing shapeshifters. Well, somebody I ran into earlier today was playing shapeshifters. This deck, you may notice, also has a lot of other board wipes. We've got Meat Hook Massacres and Blood on the Snow. We've got ways to bring things back, Agadeem's Awakening, and some cheeky one-ofs. My favorite of which is Rise of the Dreadmarn. It's very funny if you or your opponent wipes the board when it's full of creatures, and then you spit out a whole bunch of zombies. And we're a zombie deck, so we're allowed to do that. So, we're going to head into the queue with Graveyard Smash. I like this hand. It's got not one, but two Champion of the Perished in it. Got Jadar, a white. So Jadar, by the way, does die to our tribal board wipe, but the zombie is still really good value. Being able to spit out a zombie every turn for the Champion of the Perished is really nice. Ranger class, all right. So they've got a 2-2 here, and I don't need to be very conservative with this Champion of the Perished. So I'm gonna go ahead and swing in here. I think it's a much better trade on the attack than on the block, because if we wait to block, they could buff it, or they could use it to fight. We see that our opponent here, it looks like they're werewolves, because red and green, but they are snow werewolves, which means that blizzard brawls are in our future. They're actually trying to decide here. Do they want to take this trade? If you want to see a fun werewolves deck, by the way, I posted one last week for Jank Tank. That's right, 2 weeks in a row we got these tribals going on here, but I was told, ooh, we should do something spooky and Halloween themed. And what's spookier than zombies? Well, skeletons. But skeleton tribal is, there's jank, and then there's whatever skeleton tribal is, which is not very good, even in historic where there's a whole bunch more skeletons. All right, great. My opponent has taken the trade. It took them a very long time to decide, though. Took them a very long time to decide. Do I want my dog to die? Yes. Yes, I do. So, our opponent, with their very nice Gaia's Blessing sleeves, is just kind of sitting here. Maybe they disconnected. Maybe their arena crashed. I'm gonna be real with you. The last 2 weeks, my arena has crashed almost every day at least once. I don't know what caused the instability, but it's definitely there. All right, so here's a Highland Forest and a second Ranger class. Hello there, puppy. Hello, I love you. I'm going to attack you. Do you want to block? It's okay, I know you didn't before, but like maybe you want to now. Maybe you want to now? Are you a good boy? Who's your good boy? Who's your good puppy? They don't want to block. Okay. I'm going to set my tainted adversary here to block. I don't have the mana to bank any decay zombies, but this means that even if they buff up their wolf, I will be able to defend against it. It will also force them to buff up their wolf if they want to attack in, either by using ranger class or something like Veil. Don't think they would, though. I really don't. I don't think that they would. I also had some consideration to something like Jadar, but with these two ranger classes down, I don't want to really set myself up for disaster. Or even if I had another land, I would have considered Champion of the Parish, so in case they blocked the white, we got another zombie, this would get a +1/+1 counter, and then we could have played another card. But our opponent is really causing us to struggle here. This is the problem with some opponents, is that they don't even show up. They're not even here. So you get to listen to me ramble about my deck instead. I want to tell you how satisfying it is to get a kill with the Meat Hook Massacre. Extremely satisfying, that's all I have to say. We've gotten a bunch of, like, stalemates. Both players have gigantic boards where it's like, oh no, what are we going to... Oh, I know what we're going to do. I'm going to kill all my creatures and it's going to win the game. All right, so we get to attack in here. It's super weird to me that they just passed open mana. Did not cast anything. Didn't buff up the ranger class. Kind of just burning their mana down here. And now we're going to do what I was mentioning before is if I had a third land last turn, I would have done this. Champion of the Perished. We swing in. If they block the white, then we get another zombie, so it's just another zombie trigger. Tainted Adversary is getting a stare down here. Ooh, okay, so the 2-3 Death Toucher being blocked by the 2-2. Are they going to block and buff? Snakeskin Veil. That seems like a very bad trade, but you know what? That's fine. I don't get to make decisions for you, Buggio. Bugio? Buggies. Big bugaboos. Oh! And here comes Tovalar! Hello there, Toblerone. I would like to attack you. And I shall. We attack them. This zombie with decay does die. This zombie is created by that interaction there. And because two creatures died, it dies and then is exiled. I could Rise of the Dreadmarn here for even more. I don't think that they're going to have a board wipe because of their colors, because of the fact that this is werewolves. So I'm just going to Rise of the Dreadmarn here. And now we have a very big Champion of the Perished. And yeah, winner, winner, chicken dinner. Look at that. We get so many zombies on the board. Victory is assured. I think any hand that has three Champion of the Perished is a good hand. So here we go. We get the zombies. Behold. Ooh, elves. All right. Another Champion of the Perished and another Champion of the Perished. We got the 3Zs, the 2Zs, and the 1Zs. In you go. A perfectly aggressive start. Ranger class, nice. They have one extra mana if they need it. We have activated Coven. Yes, we have a Coven of Zombies here. Which is, like, a little suspicious. Just a little. And with our triple Champion of the Perished, this is how human decks used to roll, by the way, with Champion of the Perished. You just play tons of 1-drops and 2-drops. And we're swinging in with everybody. Maybe they'll, like, double block on this one. Yeah, that's what they're doing. They're double blocking on the Champion of the Perished, the little one, the 3-3. We're gonna take out the Dig Dog and hit them for 9. They're down to 8 life. Old Growth Troll. So this is like a straight up... just mono green. But the matchmaker was just feeling extra cruel. So we're gonna swing in with everybody. We have a Meat Hook Massacre for cleanup if we need it. for x equals 1. You can also do this for x equals 0 just to get, like, on death procs. Doesn't matter. We win. Great job. Great job, zombies. A nice quick game. Aggro versus aggro. Can they fix it? Yes, they can. All right, we've got two drops. And then removal. If we ever get more lands. Will we get more lands? That's the question we should be asking. So I got triple blade stitch scab, so I guess I'll try and chain those together. Ooh, acquisitions expert. I think I can drop the white. Cool. Here comes the scab. Gross. Ooh, elite spellbutter. No, don't look at this. They're gonna hit the crippling fear. Hi, this is my hand. It's perfectly normal. Oh, no, they hit soul shatter. Maybe they have another one in hand, so they're just trying to cut me off from it this turn. Very, very possible. So here's another scab. And I am thinking about swinging in. I don't think I'm going to, but I am going to show them that I did get another land here. Ooh, Professor of Symbology does not make me discard, does not hit my hand at all, in fact. They're swinging with that, they know it's going to die. None of you are zombies, which is the only thing that will survive this onslaught! Bye, guys! And we swing in for 6. Boop, boop, freshly cleaned board. My favorite. Environmental sciences. Oh, check out that circle. That one's got good dirt in it. Sure does. For 2 mana, they have the Elderfang Disciple. They're going to make me discard, and I'm going to discard the Champion of the Perished over the Blade Stiff Scab, just because these things are just really good in multiples. I'm noticing that they are running a lot of clerics, but also like a rogue? I don't really know what's going on here. I'm just going to play this out as a land because it gets me the Soul Shatter next turn. And I feel like they're going to make me discard again. Yeah, okay, so I made the right choice. I would have had to have discarded that. And instead, we get to eliminate a blocker. And if they don't have 2 blockers, then we have lethal. I mean, like, removal would also do the trick. Like, it would stop me. Are things happening? I think they might be about to sacrifice the expert. Rite of Oblivion, yep. Yeah, I have not seen this card yet outside of Limited, but I think that was a perfectly fine play from them. I'm going to go ahead and swing in. I'm going to hold this swamp, pretend that I have something that's not a swamp. It's a swamp. It's a swamp. We've got our Soul Shatter here. I love this art. Wiley Becker makes some really cool art. Elderfang Disciple, I discard my swamp. Okay, it was nothing. Here's the Soul Shatter on the Disciple. And we attack. And it's lethal. Great work, zombies! A fine spooky time against Bunghouse. Our Halloween-themed deck is here to bring the hurt. Shambling Ghast. Alright, I will just kind of hope that they don't have a way to sacrifice it. Here's Champion of the Perished. Ooh, Kalain. Kalain's very cool. Hi, Kalain. You gonna make some, like, big spooky zombies? Probably. Tainted Adversary. Zoom. Enhance. Not going to attack him, though, because I don't really want to trade for, like, Shambling Ghast. Ooh, that was a nice get. So here comes the scab. And Dungeon Crawler. And I'm playing out all of these because I want the Champion of the Perished to be as big as possible. And we're swinging in here. We got 8 damage come through. They're gonna chump block with the Ghast, probably get themselves a treasure, or kill the Crawler. My guess is they're going to get the treasure, though. Yeah, because there's There's board wipes in this sort of deck. There's usually gold spans, which they can make extra, extra large with something like Lane. And there it is, XXL gold span. They attack and hit me for 6. Ow. Oof. Owie. And I'm going for the Death Priest of Merkel. Because it's giving me just so much damage here. It's like Crippling Fear, I could kill Kalane. Meat Hook Master, I could kill one of my creatures and one of their creatures. But why do that when I can bring them down to 6 life? What do you got, Goldspan Dragon? A whole lot of mana? And a whole lot of hurt? Oh, I don't like the look of that. What's it gonna be? They have so much. They're gonna meet Hook Massacre. No! That gains them life! Sag. A little sad Meat Hook Massacre. I was gonna Meat Hook Massacre you. But you beat me to it. Oh, wait a minute. This deck has white mana in it? Sure, why not? I got more Kalanes, the third Kalane. A little bit of Deadly Disputin, a Swamp, and a Pathway. Fireblade Charger. Nice. Well, I can kill 2 of those. Check this out. I'm going to name... This is my concession right here. Don't sacrifice in response. They did in response. And we got app-napped. Rip. Oh, when I say we got app-napped, I mean we were the victims of that card killing us on its death trigger because of active player, non-active player being the order which the triggered abilities trigger. I was the active player. Mine goes on the stack first, resolves last, theirs resolve first. I get drained for the final damage. App-napped. I will keep this hand against Lenadawin. I like their Tamio and their bird. I would not a win too. Here we go. We got Champion of the Perished and then nothing else. But I do have this Draugr Necromancer and it's one of those like fun cards that's in this deck because I really like Draugr Necromancer. Not necessarily because I think it's a really, really strong card in the meta. But it's fun, and it's really fun with board wipes, and isn't, like, magic all about fun? No? Just me? Alright, that's fine. Champion of the Parish is gonna swing on in for 2 damage here. Prosperous Innkeeper is just like, having a really nice time. What a nice man. Ooh, Quandrex Cultivator. Looks like somebody is Simic ramping. I'm gonna go ahead and get out Draugr Necromancer. And attack with the Tainted Adversary. They take the 2. What could they be ramping to? Renin 7, Coma, Scoot Swarm, Frog. I play a deck that runs Crabs and Frogs. And Turtle Druids, too. Blue. Blue mana. More blue mana. Okay. Guess I'll play what I got. I want to keep back the Draugr Necromancer. Hoping that they would block there. They did. And what that gives me is... my very own Turtle Druid. I don't have forest or islands, do I? No, I have 2 islands. No, we're good. Alright, there. Snow-covered island. Did it. Nailed it. Look, now I can play my Scab. Jessica's Chariot. I could use a little bit of a board wipe right now, couldn't I? All according to Kaikaku. Yes, all according to plan. Look at all of these little creatures. Let's go ahead and do it. Here comes the blade-stitched scab. Increase the power of all these here critters. And then, the white. Keep on keeping on. Make them even stronger. And we're gonna swing in with you, and, like, you can just get bodied or eaten by the chariots. I feel like I should probably keep you back. I'll keep it back. You should bug with this, though. It would make me happy. Okay. No kitties? More cultivators for me! Huzzah! I can't play it this turn. And I guess I'm out of islands. Ooh, uh-oh. Epiphany. Epiphany means time for birds, I guess? Time for birds. They're kind of just sitting on a hall of storm giants here. Oh, they're going to steal my Draugr Necromancer. Well, that gives me no good plays here. I guess I'll swing in with this zombie and chill. I don't know why you're doing this, but I'd like you to stop. Because I want to protect it, because I had a board wipe. Ta-da! I made another one! Are you proud of me, Dad? Ooh, Storm the Festival. They get two permanents. Which two permanents do they get? They get a second Essica's Chariot and a land. It was, a third Hall of the Storm Giants? Yes. And here comes this Essica's Chariot. Going to swing in. Any of the creatures of mine that die, they get with the ice counters. It's weird. It's like creatures your opponents own in exile with ice counters. So like if they exiled their own Quandrix Cultivator, they would not get it. I know. Whack. Truly whack. I don't really need to be attacking you with this, because they just jump block it. Well, at least now we got Narfi. Hey, Narfi, how you doing? Oop, they're storming again. Yeah, they do have a lot of mana. They got a Prosperous Innkeeper and a Root Coil Creeper, so that's going to gain them a lot of life. They do now have a card with Flashback in exile, so they could sacrifice a Root Coil Creeper to go get it. And I have Tainted Adversary, who I can hit twice. Nope, just once. I counted bad. That's enough for me. Look at all those zombies! Look at all those little zom-zoms! I think they're gonna storm the festival again. Do it! Do it! And again and again and again until they hit their Rens and Sevens or whatever other spooky spells they got. Hey, look, it was Renin 7. Nailed it. They made an 11-11 tree. Big tree. That's a land. I need things that are bigger and better than that. As an example, not a land. Well, if Narfi dies, I can bring back Narfi at instant speed. I could even do it twice. Oh, Narfi. You're worth 3 mana. You're not worth 5 mana. Not even on a board full of zombies. They're storming again. They got Essica's Chariot and a land. Their fourth Hall of Storm Giants. And they milled Imrith, Renin 7, and Crafted Identity. Well, this bird's just like, tweet, tweet. I'm getting them.
I'm getting them.
You sure are, sweetheart. I'll love you, babe. Love you. Now imagine that they're going to once again storm the festival. I'm just, like, hoping for a board wipe. That's my best bet. Ooh, Epiphany, though. No, they're taking extra turns. Want to buy Metek Massacre off the top. I might not be able to kill that, but I can kill a lot of cats and birds and hobbits. Wow, that sounds awful when I say it like that. Oh, okay, everybody's coming in. Okay, Narfi, we gotta block that. How's about some of you on some of you? That's fine. That's fine. And that's fine. I feel like we prevented the most damage here. Am I dead? I don't think I'm dead. And behold, the Narfi returns. Oh, no, wait. It got exiled? It got exiled because they still had the Draugr Necromancer. Then they take the extra turn, and then we die. Oof, ow, ow, owie, owie, oof, oof, ow. I think I got one more game left in me. I wish I had Hot Pot right now, and my opponent's name is Hot Pot, and I'm hungry for them. But you're not allowed to eat your opponents in Magic the Gathering, so we'll have to wait. All right, I've got the potential to play Champion of Perish, into Late Stitch Scab. All right, let's do this. And look, we even have our little Metek Massacre for fun and profit. Hello. Hello, ma'am. Hello, would you like the party? In true zombie fashion, I'm just talking about eating you. Would you like to duel? Oh, okay, I get the keep. Let's go. Behold, the champion of the perished! Monogreen? Could be monogreen. Nope. Gruul. Okie dokie. I'm going to bolt that in and forget that I had the wrong colors of mana. Oops! I don't know why. I thought I had blue. No, I played it for black for that. Well, I paid 3 life for no reason, so to make myself totally look smarter, I'm going to play this Metek Massacre for 0. That's right. That's going to make them think we have 2 of them. We're just chilling. I got other board wipes. We're fine. Turn your misplays into fun plays. All right, here comes the Rocket Dog. Ow! And here comes Champion of Perished into the Scab. I'm going to attack in because I don't mind trading these on a block. How you doing, Rocket Dog? Who gave this dog a jetpack? I assume she built it herself. Oh, they're coming in. Coming in hot. All right, here we go. Champion of the Perished in front of the Storm Seeker. Does it get a +1/+1 counter? Oh, it's getting Stolen Vitality. I did not expect that. I have not seen that card outside of Limited yet. Aw, Kissick Naturalist. That's nice. You guys are cute. You guys are cute dogs. But you know what you're not? Zombies. You sure aren't. And that's going to be it for today's Jank Tank. As always, thank you to Channel Fireball for making this video possible, and thank you for watching. If you want to watch these get recorded live, you can do so at twitch.tv/Amazonian. That's where I stream every single day, except for Tuesdays. Except sometimes also Tuesdays. I hope to see you there. Bye.